Planet is the natural world's soaring achievement. Clues to how the earliest flies took to the skies can be found in the ancient rainforests of Borneo.
We human beings are latecomers to the skies. And although we might think that we're now pretty good at it, the natural world, with the help of several billion years of evolution, has produced a dazzling range of aeronauts whose talents are far beyond ours.
The story of how animals managed to colonize the air is truly astonishing. First into the skies were insects. But after having had the skies to themselves for about 100 million years, a new group of animals took to the air. Vertebrates, creatures with backbones. I am being winched up into one of the tallest trees here, in search of a creature that could give us a hint of how backbone animals first took to the air.
Hidden among these leaves of this fern high up here in the canopy is a very remarkable little frog. It's a harlequin tree frog, and it's a very, very good climber. It spends most of its life up here clambering around in the branches. Here, it's away from the numerous predators there are that might attack it down on the forest floor. But if in fact a predator were able to get up here, can't it? A snake perhaps? Well, the tree frog has a remarkable trick for defense.
The frog's descent, and so enables it to make a relatively safe landing. The vertebrates made their first forays into the air around 260 million years ago. And it's very likely that some of these pioneers used skinny membranes to control their falls in much the same way as this little frog does.
For many creatures, flight has become the ultimate superpower. The insects took advantage of it with such success that they are now the most numerous and widespread animals on the planet.
Emerging from beneath ground, where it has lived and fed as a larva, is the beetle, one of the biggest in the world. The Atlas beetle. Males like this one are armed with long horns, powerful weapons with which to compete with rivals for a mate. It now spends most of its time above the ground, barging its way through the undergrowth where it feeds on tree sap and fallen fruit. This hefty, powerful creature may not look as if it could fly, but it can. At key moments in its life, it takes to the air to look for new sources of food, and, of course, a female.
All this burrowing and rummaging around could injure delicate flight wings. So beetles have hardened the front pair to form this pair of protective covers. And the delicate flight pair are stowed away in safety underneath.
To see how the wings are folded away beneath their covers, we need to wait for takeoff.
Thank you.
The wings are stretched to their full size. Landings can be clumsy too. And now those fragile wings must be carefully packed away beneath their covers. They're guided by a line of tiny hairs at the base of the abdomen. These grip the wings and help push them into position. The beetle does it with all the care and precision that a skydiver uses when packing away his parachute.
The beetle way of life proved astonishingly successful. There are over 370,000 different species of beetle so far discovered. Unbelievable figure.
Over 100 million years after the insects, the birds took to the skies, dazzling the natural world with their extraordinary skill as aerial acrobats and stealthy hunters, crossing oceans and continents to conquer every landscape on Earth, even the skies above man-made urban jungles.
To watch a bird that has evolved into